Good morning one and all. Today we'll start new chapter, that is third chapter. It is a pulse modulation. So now we are entering into the digital domain. So in the first and second unit we have discussed about analog modulation and the noise analysis of that analog modulation techniques. Now we'll start with the sampling theorem. First of all, how to sample a signal? So to sample a signal, first of all we should take a continuous time signal and we have to multiply that with the train of impulse. Okay, so what is train of impulses? How does it look like? So if you take, this is a line. Now this is a train of impulse. This is 0, this is TS, this is 2TS, and this is minus TS, this is minus 2TS, so on. The strength 1. Now this is called train of impulse. Now how to denote this? This is delta of T minus summation delta of T minus NTS. Summation goes from n equal to minus 2 plus infinity. Now it is a train of impulses. And it is periodic with a period of much? TS. It is periodic with a period TS. Okay, because after every TS seconds the impulse is repeating. Okay, so this is the train of impulse which is periodic with period TS. Now what is TS is called? It is called as sampling period. Actually it is called sampling period or sampling interval. Obviously 1 by TS is equal to FS. What is FS is called? Sampling rate. It is called sampling rate or sampling frequency. Okay, so this is the notation of train of impulses. Now this is how you get if you expand that summation. Sampling frequency or sampling rate. FS is known as sampling frequency or sampling rate. Now we'll discuss uniform sampling. So how to sample a signal? This is called uniform sampling or ideal sampling. Now how it is defined? How to implement the sampling process? First you take a continuous time signal. This is M of T. Okay. Now multiply that with train of impulses. What is this? Impulses, train of impulses. Okay, so if you multiply this with this, you get this. What it is called as? M over line of T. So what it is called? Sampled signal. What it is called? Sampled signal. Okay, so this is a continuous time signal into train of impulses, you get M line of T, that is sampled signal. Now obviously here what is sampled signal? M line of T equal to, here multiplying continuous time signal M of T with train of impulses. But what is train of impulses? This. Okay, we denote with train of impulses with what? What is the notation of this? This is nothing but delta of TST. It is denoted with delta of TST. So obviously this is equal to M of T into summation delta of T minus NTS. Okay. Now, if take the multiplication inside the summation, what will happen? So, M line of T is equal to summation M of T into delta of T minus NTS. Obviously, what is M of T into delta of T minus NTS? It's a property of the S&S. What is the property? Sampling property. Now, finally, what do you get? Summation N equal to minus 2 plus infinity M of NTS into delta of T minus NTS. This is the sampled signal, M line of T. Here, so which means this is the one of the important topics in our course. You must know how to sample a signal. So we also represent like this. Sometimes M of T, one more way of writing this, sampled with period TS, you get M line of T. This is one more way of representing the sampling process. Okay, now which means sampling means these samples will represent the signal M of T. Okay, so these few number of impulses represent this M of T, continuous time signal. That is the meaning of sampling. You are taking only few points which represents the entire signal, which means, so the signal is continuous signal, but from this signal we are taking few points, few values. Those points or values represent the entire signal, so they are called samples. Okay, now so this is the mathematical expression for the sampled signal. Now, till now we have done in time domain. So let us get into the frequency domain. So time to frequency domain is done by what transform? Fourier transform. Okay. So here, one thing you must know is, yeah. So this is the Fourier transform of train of impulses. What I told you is, I have taken train of impulses n equal to minus 2 plus infinity del of T minus NTS. This is the train of impulses in time domain. So if take Fourier transform to this, again you get train of impulses. That is one of the important Fourier transform pairs you must remember. Summation del of F minus NFS. So this is train of impulses, it is also train of impulses. So if take a Fourier transform to train of impulses, again you get train of impulses. Okay, the extra term is FS. What is FS? Sampling rate. FS equal to, obviously you know, that is 1 over TS. Okay, so this is a Fourier transform of train of impulses. Now, so let us do the analysis in frequency domain. In time domain, okay, so let me write here M line of T, that is sampled signal. What is this sampled signal? How to get this? You multiply M of T with train of impulses. So let us get into the frequency domain. How to do it? Take the Fourier transform. Okay, now here what happens, M line of T becomes capital M line of F, that equal to M of T becomes generally m of f. This product will become convolution. Okay. Now just now I told you, so the Fourier transform of this impulse train is again impulse train, but what is that? Extra fs summation delta of f minus nfs. Now I am getting into the frequency domain. Okay. Now this equal to m of f into fs into summation delta of f minus nfs. Obviously, again, you can take this m of f, sorry, something is missing, convolution. Now here, again, you can take this m of f inside a summation, then what will become fs summation m of f convolution delta of f minus nfs. So then what happens? Then what happens? That equal to fs summation m of, this is a property of convolution. What becomes? F minus nfs. Okay. So what I want to say is, let me write one more time, m dash m line of t equal to m of t convolution, sorry, m of t into summation delta of t minus nts. This is the time domain. In a frequency domain, if you take Fourier transform, it becomes m over line of f, that equal to fs summation delta of f minus nfs. Okay, so this is the in time domain sampling, sampled signal. But what is this? What is this is called, obviously, in the frequency domain, it's called spectrum of sampled signal. Okay, what do you mean by this? What is m line of f? That is the Fourier transform of what signal? This signal. So if you take Fourier transform to this signal, you are getting capital M line of f. Okay, what is that? That equal to summation fs summation fs summation, here I have written a mistake, here it should be, here it should be what, m summation m of f minus nfs. What is m of f? What is m of f? That is Fourier transform of this signal. If you take Fourier transform to the m of t, you get m of f. Now everything I have written in the frequency domain. Okay. So what is this m of f actually? M over line of f actually? M over line of f is nothing but sum of copies of the original message spectrum, original spectrum of m of t. Why? Because if you expand the above expression, what do you get? If it's common, you get m of f plus fs plus m of f plus m of f minus fs plus so on so on. Now this is spectrum of sample signal. It contains shifted versions of original spectrum. Okay, m of f is the spectrum of m of t. What do you have in the spectrum of sample signal? You just have shifted versions. They are called copies. Copies of original spectrum. Because they are just shifted. Nothing else has happened to them. But not only that, they are scaled by fs. They are multiplied with fs. What happened to the spectrum of sample signal? A scaling with fs is happening, and after that, sum of copies of the original spectrum m of f. They are just shifted versions. Okay. Now, so let us draw the spectrum of this m over line of f. Let us draw this. How does it look like? Now we take some conditions. Case 1. If fs is more than 2fm. Okay, before that, so let me write one more thing before proceeding further. So let us take, this is m of t, this is t, this is m of t. Now for this, if you take the Fourier transform, suppose you are getting something like this. Let us assume that this spectrum of m of t, this is 0, this is fm, this is minus fm, this is f. What is this? This is m of f, the spectrum of m of t, original spectrum. So what is the bandwidth of this spectrum that equal to fm? It is also known as highest frequency component. Highest frequency component. Highest frequency component. Okay. Now I am assuming that the spectrum of m of t is like this, with a bandwidth fm, or highest frequency component fm. Now, so I want to draw the spectrum of sample signal, that is, I want to draw m line of f. How does it look like? Okay. For this, I will take some conditions. What I take is, fs is more than 2fm, case 1. First of all, what is fs? Sampling rate. What is fm? That is highest frequency component of m of t or m of f. Okay. Case 2, fs is exactly equal to 2fm. Case 3, fs is less than 2fm. In these three cases, let us draw the spectrum of sampled signal m line of f, capital M line of f. So why I am assuming these conditions, we will come to know a little bit later. Now case 1, whenever fs is more than 2fm, what will happen? Okay, so first of all, what is m line of f expression? That is fs summation m of f minus n fs. Now draw this by assuming fs is more than 2fs. Sorry, fs is more than 2fm. Now, first of all, where is m of f? This is m of f. It is shifted by fs. Okay? Fs to fs, so on, so on. Okay, let me draw this. First of all, keep m, this is varies from n equal to minus to plus infinity. Now, first, let us take n equal to 0. If n equal to 0, you get fs into m of f. I am writing m of f. What is m of f? Somewhere here. This is 0, this is fm, this is minus fm. It is for n equal to 0. For n equal to 1, so fs is there, don't forget. If n equal to 1, whatever, m of f minus fs, which means this is shifted towards right side by fs. But fs is more than 2fm, then what will happen? You get one more copy here. So what is this point? Obviously its point would be fs minus fm. This point would be fs plus fm. So obviously you get some more point here, some more copy, one more copy here. it goes on like this. Okay, so all are scaled by fs, scaled with fs. What is this m of f? What is this m of f minus fs? What is this m of f plus fs plus plus, so on so on, it continues like this. But remember, there is a gap between them. So this point is fm, this point is fs minus fm. There is a gap because we assumed that fs is more than 2fm. Case 1. Case 2. Case 2, what is case 2? If fs is exactly equal to 2fm, means what happens? Here, if fs is equal to 2fm, what is fs minus fm? Fm, which means the copies will touch each other. They are called copies or replicas. They will touch each other. In case 3, what will happen? They will overlap. Okay? Yeah. This is the case 1. Whenever fs is more than 2fm, the copies or replicas have a gap. There is a gap between them. There is a gap between the successive copies. Case 2. Whenever fs is less than exactly equal to 2fm, the copies are exactly touching each other. They are just touching each other. Case 3. Whenever fs is less than 2fm, the copies are overlapping. Here they are overlapping. Okay. So that overlapping is called as aliasing. It is called as aliasing. Okay. In case 3, whenever fs is less than 2fm, what will happen? They will overlap. What is happening here? This is the overlap. And this is another overlap. So they are overlapping with the successive copies. Okay, this is 0. This overlap is called aliasing effect. What is called aliasing effect? When it happens in third case, whenever the sampling rate is less than twice the fm. Okay. Okay. So that is about the spectrum of sampled signal. Okay. Now, so next. Okay. So there is something called reconstruction. Okay. What a reconstruction means? So from the sampled signal, okay, first of all, what is sampling? So from this signal, we got some samples. This is called sampling. What is reconstruction? Reverse of sampling, which means this reverse. So from M line of T, you get M of T. Okay, from M line of T, you get M of T. So this is sampling, that is reconstruction. This is called sampling. It is called reconstruction. Or it is also called interleaving. It is in time domain. Okay. Now I explained the concept of reconstruction in time domain. Okay. In the frequency domain, what happens? This is what happens. So from m ln of f, should get m of f. So from the sampled spectrum, you should get the original spectrum. How it is possible? With the low pass filter. Okay. So you look at the spectrum. So I've taken case one. In the case one, what is the condition? Fs is more than 2fm. If it is so, this is a sampled spectrum. This is a sampled spectrum. If you pass this spectrum through this low pass filter, what will happen? With the cutoff frequency, actually fm, you can write fm. So the remaining copies will be rejected, except this copy is accepted, which means this is the output of the low pass filter. All the replicas, all the copies are rejected, eliminated, only one copy is present, that is this. What is this? This is m of f. Okay, this is in frequency domain, this is in time domain. Okay, whether you do analysis in frequency or time domain, both are same. Okay, now so the reconstruction or interleaving is possible with a low pass filter. Okay, but remember, I explained only in the case one. We have remaining two cases. Let us go for case two here. In case two, if I use an ideal low pass filter, can I get m of f? Yes. Okay. In second case also, you can get the m of f. Correct? Second case also, reconstruction possible. In second case also, reconstruction possible. Here possible, here also possible. Okay. Third case. In third case, the copies of original spectrum are overlapping. Okay, so even though you pass through ideal low pass filter, what happens? You get a distorted version of m of f, not m of f. What do you get here? If you pass through ideal low pass filter, what the output you get? You don't get m of f exactly. What do you get here is, what do you get? You get something like this. Okay, so you get this portion. That is not m of f, that is a distorted version of m of f. Obviously, so in third case, the reconstruction is not possible. But so here, what I have used is a low pass filter for reconstruction. What kind of low pass filter? Ideal low pass filter. Okay, but you know already, ideal filters are non-causal, they are not practically realizable. Okay, so in the first case, I don't need ideal filter. Why? Because suppose this is ideal filter. If you have ideal filter, it is well and good. But if it is not ideal, suppose it has got some roll off, something like this. Still there is no problem. In the case one, even though the low pass filter may not be ideal, still recovery is possible. Still reconstruction is possible. But in the case two, you must need ideal filter. If it is not ideal, again there is a problem in the case 2. Okay, so strictly speaking, recovery is possible only in case 1, but theoretically we can say that recovery is possible in both cases, case 1 and case 2. But in case 2, you need an ideal low pass filter, which is not realizable practically. But theoretically we say that in case 1, case 2, you can able to reconstruct. But in case 3, it is impossible to reconstruct, even though if you use a ideal low pass filter. In case 3, it is not the problem with low pass filter, it is a problem with the overlapping. So case 3 impossible, case 2 possible with the ideal low pass filter, case 1 possible with practical low pass filter also. Here, so the reconstruction is possible theoretically, I can say, in case 1 plus case 2. What is case 1? Fs is more than 2fm, case 2, Fs is equal to 2ff. But combinedly, what you can write? Fs should be more than or equal to twice the ff. This is a condition for reconstruction or interleaving. Okay, so someone may ask, whenever reconstruction is possible, when it is possible, whenever the sampling rate is more than twice the highest frequency component or twice the bandwidth of the original signal. Okay, so what is the minimum sampling rate required for the reconstruction? What is the minimum of this? Actually, if I ask you x is greater than or equal to 2, what is the minimum value of x? That is equal to 2. In the same way, here fs is greater than or equal to 2fm. What is the minimum value of the sampling rate? 2fm. The minimum sampling rate required for reconstruction is called Nyquist rate. What is called? Nyquist rate. What is Nyquist rate equal to? 2fm. So we define Nyquist rate with nq. So Nyquist rate, that is the minimum value of sampling rate that is required for the reconstruction, that is the twice the fm. Nq or nr, Nyquist rate, very very important. What is called? Nyquist rate. Okay, now this is a reconstruction. It is possible with the low pass filter, that's it. Now this is sampling theorem. Aliasing distortion occurs whenever fs is less than 2fm. To avoid aliasing, we need to have a fs should be more than or equal to 2fm. That is called sampling theorem. So the minimum sampling rate required for perfect reconstruction is called Nyquist sampling rate. It is equal to 2fm. This is sampling theorem. What is it saying? An analog signal can be represented in its samples and can be recovered back when sampling rate fs is greater than or equal to twice the highest frequency component of missing signal fm. That is, so you can able to reconstruct the original signal if and only if fs is more than or equal to twice the fm. If it is reversed, you cannot get reconstruction because of aliasing distortion. What is aliasing distortion? Overlapping of successive copies of the original spectrum. The reconstruction. So here I explained reconstruction, but you can also study in time domain. So because you might have studied these things already, if you are interested, you can go through them also. They are not required. Okay, one more thing. So if fs is 2fm, it is called critical sampling. Okay, if fs is 2fm, it is called critical sampling. If fs is more than 2fm, it is called oversampling. If it is less than 2fm, it is called undersampling. So what is the basic idea of these things? Okay, suppose in this undersampling, you take less number of samples, which means these three samples cannot represent this signal, obviously, no? Okay, here oversampling. Here for the same signal, I have taken more samples. Obviously, samples are more, they can represent the signal. Okay, here, which means here I have taken some samples. These are the minimum sample required to represent the signal. Okay, that is simple meaning. Okay, so here I have taken more samples. Obviously, you get more accuracy in reconstruction. Here, these are the minimum sample required for the perfect reconstruction. What is reconstruction? You just join these samples like this. Okay, For reconstruction, we are passing the signal through low pass filter. What is low pass filter? Some kind of integrator. Okay, it just adds these peaks. Okay, so these are minimum samples required for reconstruction. That is called critical sampling. If you take more samples, you get more accuracy. That is quite obvious. Okay, but if you take less samples, with these samples, you cannot represent the signal. That is simple meaning. Okay. You go through these things and you solve these problems also. Okay. So that is about the sampling, right? So I'll explain the quantization concept in the next class. Thank you.